My name is Nicole Black, and I am an inventor in the Lemelson-MIT Student Prize competition. My primary invention is Phonographed, and Phonographed is a novel 3D printed device that matches the architecture of the normal eardrum. And your eardrum can become damaged through a variety of mechanisms, including ear infections, sticking cotton swabs in your ear canal, and blast injuries. And Phonographed is unique because once it's implanted, the material begins to degrade and become replaced by native tissue, matching the circular and radial structure of your normal eardrum to enable sound conduction at both low and high frequencies. So chronic eardrum perforations happen to about 30 million people worldwide each year. And of these people, only about 10% of them undergo a tympanoplasty surgery to repair their eardrum. A lot of these patients are afraid of general anesthesia and being in the hospital for a long period of time, or cannot access a trained ear, nose, and throat surgeon or hospital setting for these procedures. And so Phonographed is unique because it can be placed in a clinic setting without general anesthesia while still using the same billing code. So hospitals can be reimbursed for tympanoplasty procedures to the same extent while lowering their overhead costs and allowing surgeons to do more procedures per day. And so this could potentially open up tympanoplasty as an option for millions of more patients worldwide each year. Currently, we are finalizing the device architecture for Phonographed, and so really we hope to get Phonographed into the hands of ear, nose, and throat surgeons to use this with patients within the next 2 years. Through novel materials and 3D printing approaches, I am aiming to create a world where we can program the eardrum to heal itself following injury.
My name is Mira Mufarij, and I'm an inventor in the Lemelson-MIT Student Prize competition. Pregnancy can be a time of major change. To make sure both mom and baby are healthy, doctors can use tools like ultrasound imaging to get a basic idea. But these tools provide an incomplete picture. And what's missing, like a mother's risk of pregnancy complications, can prove deadly. So how do we monitor these complications? I built powerful new diagnostics that combine cell-free RNA measurements with statistics. Cell-free RNA is the subset of RNA molecules in plasma, the liquid portion of blood. So far, we've developed 3 new tests using a small, routine blood draw from a pregnant mom. The first can predict how far along a pregnancy is with about the same accuracy as ultrasound. This has promising implications for an inexpensive test that can be used in the field as opposed to in a hospital. The second can predict a person's risk of preterm birth up to 2 months in advance of delivery. Preterm birth is the leading cause of infant death, and it affects 1 in 10 people worldwide. And right now, there's almost no warning sign for preterm birth. Doctors still just guess if you're at risk. The third can predict a person's risk of preeclampsia in the first trimester, whereas it's usually diagnosed in the third. Preeclampsia is a multi-organ syndrome that affects 1 in 20 people in the US, like Serena Williams and Beyonce. It also disproportionately affects Black mothers in the US. And yet, if we can predict it in the first trimester, doctors can prescribe a drug to reduce one's risk of ever developing the syndrome. Millions are affected by pregnancy complications every year. Globally, there's a $3 billion market for such tests that is covered by insurance and growing at a rate of 17% per year. Large-scale preclinical validation of this work is ongoing at Mirvi, a startup based on this technology. Diagnostics like these empower patients and providers, which means healthier pregnancies and healthier babies.
We are Inerva, and we are inventors in the Lemelson-MIT Student Prize competition.
There are currently 20 million peripheral nerve injury patients in the U.S., and in cases of severe trauma such as amputations, the damaged nerves tend to grow disorganized nerve tumors or neuromas that cause debilitating pain and are prevalent in up to 80% of amputees, leading to a $27,000 cost burden per patient. Existing interventions either cannot prevent neuroma or stifle recovery. A promising approach known as targeted muscle reinnervation, or TMR, sutures the severed nerve to a smaller motor nerve. This facilitates reinnervation for neuroma prevention and has been demonstrated to be highly compatible with advanced prosthetics. However, the size mismatch between the severed nerve and motor nerve still results in a significant failure rate, with 30% of post-op patients experiencing neuroma.
To combat this failure, we have developed a conduit device that solves the issue of nerve size mismatch. Inspired by the simple funnel, Our device is composed of an outer polymer scaffold and inner biological gel. The scaffold, made from electrospinning a biocompatible polymer, may be molded and crimped into an adaptable funnel shape. The gel, made from a proprietary nanofiber hydrogel composite and biological nerve inhibitor, reduces inflammation and biochemically guides nerve growth. When combined together, the gel and scaffold form a device that is the first of its kind to both promote functional nerve recovery and inhibit neuroma formation.
We put our nerve conduit to the test in a pilot small animal in vivo study. Our data shows that our device leads to tapered reinnervation without neuroma formation and supports better axonal guidance and muscle function. We are targeting a $2.7 billion nerve injury market, specifically the 185,000 new amputees each year in the U.S., combined with 7.8% of the existing 2 million amputees who require repeat surgery. We are Inerva, and we are dedicated to rejuvenating the lives of nerve injury patients.
Hi, my name is Hillary Johnson, and I'm an inventor in the Lemelson-MIT Student Prize competition. My invention is a centrifugal pump with adaptive geometry that changes the volume of the pump in real time to match the flow rate of the system. This improves pump efficiency, operating range, and reliability. Pumps are integral to daily life. Centrifugal pumps move fluid through our industrial and municipal systems, including clean water distribution, wastewater treatment, crop irrigation, oil and gas production, and pumped hydro energy storage. Centrifugal pumps consume 6% of U.S. electricity annually, which is equivalent to the energy output of 56 Hoover dams. Systems have variable flow. For example, in residential areas, the flow rate is higher in the mornings when people take showers, and often lower midday. A significant source of inefficiency is that pumps have limited adjustment to meet this fluctuating demand. The Department of Energy estimates that 10 to 20% of energy could be saved by operating at the best efficiency point. Using fluid fundamentals and experiments, I showed that varying the pump geometry in response to this fluctuating demand enables best efficiency operation across a range of flows. Then, using precision machine design principles, I invented a dynamic pump mechanism which expands the pump during higher flows and contracts during lower flows. Our patent-pending mechanism adapts to the optimal geometry for best efficiency. The current prototype I'm testing enables a 6x increase in operational range and can operate collaboratively with variable speed drives. When COVID hit, I couldn't access my experimental setup, so I pivoted and built a backyard testable pump as a scalable template backed by design equations and hydraulic calculations. Now I'm scaling up to 80 gallons per minute for experiments to complete my PhD at MIT. Xylem, a global water technology company with $5 billion in annual revenue, envisions this variable volume mechanism as the first in a new category of adaptive pumps. Working at the water energy nexus, I see how climate change mandates efficient, adaptable, and resilient pump systems at terawatt scale. Growing cities also need expanded capacity for clean and wastewater, and building heating and cooling. Adaptive pumps show potential to improve the efficiency, operating range, and reliability, all with a smaller footprint than equivalent systems. A hearty thank you to all my mentors and partners, Xylem, for your collaboration.
I'm Ben Johnson.
And I'm Zane Zenz. And we're inventors in the Lemelson-MIT Student Prize competition.
Here in Nebraska and around the world, our grain supply often makes stops in on-the-farm grain bins. Grain storage is a vital step in the farm-to-fork process. Unfortunately, as much as 30% of our grain value is lost during storage due to poor management and adverse conditions. On top of this, the dangers of grain bins include farmer entrapment, auger entanglement, and long-term lung damage for agricultural workers.
The grain weevil is a grain extraction and bin management robot. It scurries across the top of the grain, engaging with the grain directly with its auger drive system and a variety of tools.
There are over 1 million grain bins storing over 15 billion bushels of grain on U.S. farms. Reaching just 5% of the farms in Nebraska alone would create 25 jobs and $7.5 million in annual revenue. We have received an initial investment from AgLaunch 365 as well as a Nebraska prototyping grant. We will begin on-the-farm pilot projects this spring to gather data for implementing autonomous features. Then we will begin our robots as a service model.
As the robot maneuvers on the grain, it increases what is called sediment gravity flow. This requires a robust set of sensors and code to keep the robot on task. Basically, the grain wheel encourages gravity to help us move grain instead of just pushing it around.
The machine seems simple enough, but the challenge is to create a mobile robot that can drive on the fluid surface of grain or steep. Putting together a machine robust enough to survive the grain bin environment and accomplish the management tasks required hundreds of hours of testing in the grain bin.
The grain wheel has the potential to not only improve the sustainability of our grain supply, but to save money and lives as well.
The grain wheel is on a mission to become an ag robot that does the work that no farmer should.
My name is Maya Berhanberger.
And I am Seung-Hwan An.
And we are inventors in the Lemelson-MIT Student Prize competition. Our team has developed a hardware and software retrofit kit to make existing power wheelchairs autonomous for use both at home and in hospitals. For people with conditions like ALS and MS, using the conventional joystick interfaces of power wheelchairs is simply not an option. Instead, they must use alternative input devices like sip and puff switches or eye tracking software, which can be prohibitively difficult to use. For these users, as well as those with arthritis, muscle fatigue, age-related hand tremors, and other conditions, we developed our autonomous wheelchair retrofit kit solution. Now let's talk about hospitals. Mid-size hospitals employ dozens of porters whose job it is to push inpatients from their rooms to their appointments in wheelchairs, regardless of whether they're injured. This results in thousands of hours of close proximity contact with patients per porter per year. Since the pandemic began, there have been numerous documented cases of porters being the flashpoints for COVID outbreaks within hospitals around the world.
Inventus is the world's first fully self-driving wheelchair that is solving both of these problems.
By taking in data from a wide array of sensors, the internal computers can then synthesize that data into a map of the environment while simultaneously localizing itself and navigating within that map. To use this, first a caretaker or a nurse pushes the wheelchair around the house or hospital, making a map of the environment and marking off relevant locations with a touchscreen interface. After that, all the user needs to do is sit down in the chair and it will take them entirely autonomously to their desired destination. We have been fortunate to partner with two of the world's largest power wheelchair manufacturers to help bring our technology to market. Our early adopter has been Toronto General Hospital. We have both co-authored a white paper with their director of imaging, validating the market need for our technology, and we are in the process of completing clinical trials as we speak.
My name is Paige Balcom, and I'm an inventor in the Lemelson-MIT Student Prize competition and co-founder of Takataka Plastics. I'm working to transform plastic waste into saleable products in Uganda. Uganda produces 600 tons of plastic waste every day, the equivalent weight of 331 cars. Most of the plastic is burnt, releasing lethal carcinogens, toxins, and greenhouse gases. I want to help my Ugandan friends address this massive environmental and public health issue and create jobs for youths who live on the street. Uganda's biggest plastic waste challenge is water and soda bottles made from PET plastic. They're littered everywhere and currently cannot be recycled anywhere in East Africa. Many developing countries face the same problem because the chemical properties of PET make it very difficult to process at a non-industrial scale. After melting, PET becomes brittle and the plastic snaps or crumbles. My invention solves this problem by recycling PET into useful products using small-scale, locally built machines and a process that alters the chemical properties of PET. My design for locally built machines is scalable across the developing world because they're low cost and easy to maintain. Our injection machine design is 85% cheaper than imported equipment. Takataka collects plastic bottles, shreds, washes, dries, melts, and molds them into wall tiles that are cheaper and more durable than the current ceramic tiles on the market. Recycling plastic waste into new products is 5.5 times better for the environment than the current practice of open burning. We just completed final product testing, have pre-orders from local customers, and are starting to market our tiles. By the end of 2021, we hope to recycle 9 tons of PET every month and employ over 35 staff. If Takataka scaled to all developing nations, the global market size is 3.6 billion consumers. We create over 700,000 jobs for vulnerable youth and remove over 2 billion kilograms of plastic waste from the environment every year.